Mad Murdock. Somebody was chewing on these walnuts. Somebody was also chewing on this guitar neck. What's going on here, bro? Hey, who did that? The Hot Sauce Guitar Kitchen episode 168, wooden tuners. This angle right here is dishes cam. I have cameras positioned all through the kitchen. Either I put them here or someone else put them there. There's kitchen, there's just cameras everywhere. Spice cabinet up here, potato chip cam, corn tortilla cam. What's up with that? That? Then look. And they were chewing on this too, bro. These cameras, anyways, you get my point. Today, we'll be using Charles E. Atchison's book, The Folk Art Instrument Builders Reference. This was put out in 2014. Charles.Atchison@gmail.com. I'm gonna have to send this guy this video, yo. http://www.charlesatchison.com. What if I'm pronouncing his name wrong? Anyways, my friend who sold me that giant great deal of a bunch of odds and ends stuff, Mike. Check out Mike Hearn. I think he's on Facebook. Mike Hearn. Philadelphia. He lives in Jersey, but he lives near Philly. Anyways. He recommended this book to me. So I've only ever used Mike Orr's book, like ever. It's a very special book to me. But he did recommend this one. I was really initially fascinated by this one because he does a thing in here where he takes a magnet and bolts and then wraps thin wire around it as the pickup. I'm just fascinated by that. I bought that wire and it was like a nightmare, dude. So I hit up, that's why if you check out Bart Blankenship's page, YouTube, he actually hand winds pickups with that exact wire. Here it is. Look. C-O-N, Spiracy. See that wire right there? He drills holes through the neck and puts a magnet next to it, and then you wrap that wire around. I just think it's fascinating, but yo, I am not the one. I tried wrapping that wire. It's hair. It's as thin as a hair, and it kept breaking. So, but anyways, I never did this before. Let's do it. Okay. Piece of wood, circle, line. Line on both sides. We'll be right back.
I'm using 4 different sizes because maybe I'll experiment with what that will do as far as turning it. Have you ever seen Japanese shamisen? Shamisen? They have like a great big thing. If you've seen them, they kind of look silly when you see them on there because they're really long, but it makes sense. If you have a lot of tension on here and you got little small pegs, I'm not sure how big this is going to be when it's done. But they have big long ones. So I guess the assumption would be is that it's easier to turn because you can use your whole fist as opposed to using your fingers. Anyways, I don't know. I'm just experimenting here because we're not using gears. We're just going this. Good afternoon, Hot Sauce Guitar Kitchen. This is the artist unknown as Tension. That's right what I said. Yeah, do you all sell friction pegs for violins and tuners? for cellos. Yeah, I want to order 1,000 of them. Nah, we got her, dude. So this is the neck that I had fun with, too much fun with. When I was shaping it, I shaped a little too deep right here. It's still cozy, but actually it went into the fretboard. See that? That was a while ago. But I got it, did. Fun. I can see this is something that I'd have to play with a little more. And right now, to tell you the honest truth, I'm really not that motivated to really master this art right now. I like it. I love the concept. This is old school. This would actually work. I could actually spend the rest of the day crafting these and making one of these. If you hit me up and you want one of these with friction pegs, I will probably buy them. The concept's awesome. Saint Romano's, this is what he wants. He wants a Baroque guitar, not broke, but a Baroque, like a 10-string, 8-string Baroque guitar with a real hard back, you know what I'm saying? The old school ones. And he wants these. And then he even wants like tied on frets. Like back in the day, you know how they use like the gut nylon strings? When you don't have metal frets, like what's that dude's name? The real famous classical guitar player? I had to look it up. But Adrian, I don't know. They use tie-on frets, dude. Like they there's a whole situation where you take frets, you get it. They tie them on here. Tie one here, and they tie it. I'm not the one right now. But like I said, you know, let's just appreciate the fact that we can get these right now and use them. Recognize even these cheap ones. If you find them cheap, take care of them.
Show me that our sweet love hasn't died. Give me one more chance to keep you satisfied.
Figure out how to adjust them if they get loose or whatever. They come in like 1, 2, 3, like 5 different parts, maybe 6 different parts. If you explode this and take this apart, it actually is like I said, it's like 4 or 5 different pieces. If you were to craft this from home, you would have to really know what you're doing. So,
little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Tell.
I have earned a brand new appreciation for those things. Hot Sauce Guitar Kitchen, wooden tuner pegs. Goom, daddy. Wooden tuning peg. Yo, to get this shot right here, I had to risk my life. See the sky? Yesterday, when I dropped my little girls off for school, it was a blue sky, and they were up there playing tic-tac-toe in the sky. You know what that means when I say they're playing tic-tac-toe in the sky? Beautiful blue day, and then they started playing tic-tac-toe in the sky. And guess what? Last night, around 7 o'clock, they started telling the children they're calling for a blizzard. Huh, they're calling for a blizzard? How would they know that? Why would they think that? Because the sky was blue, and then they were playing tic-tac-toe in the sky, and then the very next morning, the sky is raining acid rain.
Oh, hello. Yeah, B Tension, Hot Sauce Guitar Kitchen. Do you all sell violin tuning pegs and or cello pegs?
Captain Howdy, Matt Murdock, what's the status? Did you hear what he just said? Did you hear what he just said? He just said C-O-N, Spiracy. C-O-N, Spiracy, bro. Where's that kitty?
Making them now. There's little wooden peg tuners. Yeah. Wooden peg tuners, page 11. It's going to, I've never made them before. Yep. Really? You already got an order? They want me to make them? I haven't even made them yet. How many do they want? 1,000? Dude, I'm not sure if I'm trying to make 1,000 of them. I was gonna make a couple of them. And then in the future, just make them if I get orders. 1,000 of them. Doesn't anybody here make them? Well, is there anybody across the ocean that can make them for us? You know what I mean? No. 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 Everybody here is going to want $50 to get paid $50 an hour. Oh, I know. Well, I heard over there, dude, they'll work for less than 5 cents a day. We can get 1,000 of them cranked out, no problem, bro. I know, bro. USA. USA. All right, holler at me. But I'm not making 1,000 of them, dude. All right, peace. All right, so next, shape the cutout. Clamp the piece down on a block of wood and use a rasp around the edges. Don't be too aggressive with the rasp. The first goal is to take off the sharp edges. Starting to take shape already. After using the rasp, take some coarse sandpaper and really start to shape the round tuning peg. Make a cone shape with the sandpaper and twist the peg back and forth on the round to taper it. The taper is very important. You could also use a Dremel with a sanding wheel and then finish it off by hand with a medium fine grit sandpaper, whatever works best for you. So pretty much, if I'm in your community and we run out of these, Let's just say spirits are going to be at an all-time low. Davenport, do you make those wooden tuning pegs? No. Well, what are you going to do? I'll wash dishes or peel potatoes. Did you dig it? The Hot Sauce Guitar Kitchen is not necessarily looking for subscribers and for likes. Just glad you stopped by to say hi. Dude, dig it. Like right now, I'm in a place where I just feel like reading through Chronicles. Have you ever read through Chronicles, First Chronicles? He begat him, he begat him. Try reading Chronicles. Start First Chronicles and just like read it like you're reading a book. There's cool stuff in there, but it's like he... Anyways, one of the things I saw in here was First Chronicles 15:20. This is for you instrument builders or... I don't know. Harps tuned to Alamoth, a maiden-like tone. Iron Maiden? I'm just kidding. It said, no, in my Bible it said maiden-like tone. Alamoth. And then it says, harps tuned to Alamoth, lyres tuned to Sheminith, which are octave harps. Check it out. 1 Corinthians... for your instrument builders. 1 Corinthians, no, dude. 1 Chronicles 15:20. There's these little gems in the Bible, especially as it relates to stringed instruments that I find very curious. And I think Ken Johnson has a book out about the Dead Sea Scrolls and the Essenes, whatever. And he mentions on Skywatch TV, towards the end of one of the programs, that the names of the instrument, this is why I got his book, the names of the instruments in the book of Psalms may have something to do with the signs of the times as it relates to dates. Don't quote me on any of that. It could be false information. It could be misinformation. But just the just something about the idea of the fact that I find building cigar box guitars and I find octaves, the sound of octaves, like very curious. It's just like a, I don't want to say scientific. It's just like a very curious, it's a curious thing for me right now. I don't know why, I just find it fascinating. These old names and blah, blah, blah. Anyways, check that out. It's just for fun. Maybe do a Bible study or do a word study on the word Sheminith or Alamoth. Peace. The Hot Sauce Guitar Kitchen, episode 168, wooden tuning peg. C-O-N-spiracy.